Tourism officials have made it clear that the American Airlines decision is a source of concern. The flight reductions, which take effect in August, could mean that more than 1,000 visitors less every month will be arriving here. But the director of tourism does not believe that the development will spell disaster.
I think the scares that it's going to be disastrous is a knee-jerk, you know, reaction. I think we have to remain very focused. We can't jump every time something unfortunate happens. We have to continue to be strategic and ensure that we continue to promote the destination in a very responsible way.
The director of tourism says Saint Lucia cannot run to offer guarantees to the airlines, but has to be very strategic in its approach by continuing to market the destination. He disclosed that JetBlue will be putting on additional capacity, going from 4 times a week to a daily service from June to September. And should that prove successful, he says, the service could be expanded to compensate for the decline in capacity.
Well, we have a very clear strategy with regard to airlift. We know exactly what is adequate for the destination given the accommodation size. And we are focused very focused in terms of implementing that strategy as it relates to airlift. We've come from a situation where we subsidize heavily airlift into St. Lucia, and it costs us dearly, on average $7 to $9 million per year. And now we have moved into a more favorable position where we are marketing the destination and it's carrying its own.
According to Mr. Lewis, the major challenge facing airlines relates to yield, and this, he says, is affected by the price of oil, a matter that's very difficult to mitigate. However, he indicated that the whole objective is to make St. Lucia a place that is desirable to potential travelers.
If you were going to pursue that initiative on the basis of subsidizing airlift, you know it's going to defeat the purpose. We will run broke, you know, very soon. And that's why I keep on insisting that we have to be very strategic. We have to create that demand for St. Lucia, and then the airlift becomes sustainable. And that's the initiative that we are pursuing.
Mr. Lewis pointed out that while St. Lucia had more airlift last year, the planes were not full. As a result, he feels that regardless of reduced capacity, efforts must continue to market the destination. For the DBS News World, Pete Ninval reporting.